Tobia burns a fish's liver and heart, but you don't mention Tobit 8:5-7, one of the most beautiful prayers on marriage in scripture, in which Tobia prays to God to bless them. It wasn't just a case of burning a liver.
Jesus never quoted the Apocrypha. They are pagan writings.
Let's put that myth to rest. Wisdom 2:12-21. Shall I quote from the King James Version? Therefore let us lie in wait for the righteous, because he is not for our turn, and he is clean, contrary to our doings. He upbraideth us with our offending the law, and objecteth to our infamy the transgressings of our education. He professeth to have the knowledge of God, and he calleth himself the child of the Lord. He was made to reprove our thoughts. He is grievous unto us even to behold, for his life is not like other men's, his ways are of another fashion. We are esteemed of him as counterfeits. He abstaineth from our ways as from filthiness. He pronounceth the end of the just to be blessed, and maketh his boast, that God is his father. Let us see if his words be true, and let us prove what shall happen in the end of him. For if the just man be the Son of God, he will help him, and deliver him from the hand of his enemies. Let us examine him with despitefulness and torture, that we may know his meekness, and prove his patience. Let us condemn him with a shameful death, for by his own saying he shall be respected. Such things they did imagine, and were deceived, for their own wickedness hath blinded them. Does any of that sound familiar? Matthew 27:43, he trusted in God, let him deliver him now, if he will have him, for he said, I'm the Son of God. Wisdom was written before the life of Jesus. So you must believe either that wisdom is part of scripture, or that a non-scriptural book made an accurate prophecy, or that the whole thing was a freak coincidence.
Is that the only verse you have?
Well, why don't you give me one for Esther first? Where is Esther quoted in the New Testament? In your Bible, why is God never mentioned in the book of Esther?
Are you attacking the book of Esther?
I'm trying to make you decide what the basis is for your biblical canon. Esther is, naturally, the weakest target. So, how do you know that Esther is inspired scripture, while wisdom is not?
I know what books are in scripture. We see the list in the Textus Receptus.
Irrelevant. The Textus Receptus only lists New Testament books, and we agree on all the New Testament books. Let's focus on the Old Testament for now. How do you know which books are included?
Your Apocrypha only appears in the Greek texts, not in the Hebrew ones. This shows that the Apocrypha should not be equated on the same level as actual scripture.
That was before the Dead Sea Scrolls were discovered. Pieces of the Deuterocanonicals were found there in Hebrew. But that's irrelevant anyway, since Jesus and his apostles most likely used the Greek Septuagint. Put simply, the Septuagint was a Greek translation of the Hebrew scriptures, and it was in use during the time of Jesus. In Luke 4:18-19, Jesus reads directly from a scroll of Isaiah, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, he hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord." Let's read the version from Isaiah 61:1-2, "The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek, he hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord." Why are there slight differences? Was it a mistranslation? No. Like most Bibles, your King James Version translates Isaiah from Hebrew manuscripts. It naturally translates Luke from Greek, the language it was written in. Well, Luke quotes Isaiah from the Greek Septuagint. So, you have some translation differences. The opening of prison to them that are bound comes from the Hebrew. The recovering of sight to the blind comes from the Greek. There are numerous slight differences like this throughout scripture, where a New Testament quotation of the Old Testament is slightly different, because it comes from a Greek translation instead of a Hebrew one. Why is this important? Well, as you stated, the Greek Septuagint included the deuterocanonical books of the Catholic Bible. Jesus's Bible therefore most likely had these books.
The Jews agreed on the books of the Bible that Protestants have in their Old Testament.
You're referring to the Jewish Council of Jamnia. If such a council in fact happened, it would have happened in the 1st century AD, after Christianity had been established. Before this time, the Jews were not in agreement on their canon. The Sadducees believed that only the Torah, the first five books, were inspired. I already mentioned the Dead Sea Scrolls. These scrolls included parts of every book in the Protestant and Catholic Bible, except for Esther. They also included some books that are in neither of our Bibles. Philo of Alexandria, a Jewish philosopher who was alive in Jesus' lifetime, speaks as if there isn't an exact list of canon. We don't know the full list of books he considered inspired, but there are several that he never mentions, including Daniel, Ecclesiastes, and of course Esther. Milo of Sardis, who lived in the 2nd century AD, left out all of the deuterocanonical books except Wisdom. He included all of the books in your Old Testament except Esther. So I ask you, what is your biblical guarantee that the book of Esther is inspired by God, but the book of Wisdom is not? It all gets very confusing, very uncertain, and very frightening, unless you believe that the Holy Spirit inspired a group of men to infallibly choose the books in your canon.